This is why it sucks to be a tigress. It is common knowledge that tigers are solitary creatures, meaning they do not form the traditional mother, father, and offspring family structure. Nor do they form packs of family members of a certain gender like elephants do. Rather, they live all by themselves. This lifestyle suits male tigers. They can hunt, defend their territory, and enjoy the benefits of being single. But tigresses, on the other hand, don't have it that easy because life as a single parent is hard, especially in the wild. To better understand their position, let's dive into their lifestyle and explore all the struggles they face. Before going deeper into the topic, please consider supporting the channel by liking the video and subscribing. Thank you. When a tigress is ready to give birth, she will prepare a den that is in a hidden spot, protected from other predators and from bad weather. These spots are often in crevices, caves, dense grasses, or even in the hollow of a large tree, and usually provide a mat of soft grass or leaves on which she can give birth. Usually, the tigress gives birth to 3 or 4 cubs. If a litter of cubs dies for any reason, the female will be able to have another one within 5 months. Tiger cubs are born blind, weighing on average just above 2.2 pounds, 1 kilogram. Their eyes will open sometime between 6 to 12 days. However, they do not have their full vision for a couple of weeks. The tigress is solely responsible for the protection and care of her young. She spends nearly 70% of her time nursing her cubs for the first few days following birth, and only leaves for very short periods of time to drink or hunt. Despite the intensive nursing by their mother, about half of all cubs do not survive to be more than 2 years old. This is mostly attributed to the challenges the tigress faces as a single mother. Tiger cubs are vulnerable to predation from wolves, bears, lynxes, and leopards, so the mother's strategy is to spend as much time with her cubs as possible. To achieve this balance, she abandons defending her territory. Her hunting area is now less than half of what it was before. She spends less time moving, but when she has to travel, she moves more quickly, especially when returning home from a kill. A tigress may have to make some very hard decisions while parenting. Even though it is very unusual, a mother may have to kill her cubs for various reasons. If she gives birth to only one offspring, it has been observed that the tigress may kill the cub within a few days. The theory is it will bring her back into heat, so she will give birth to more cubs in her next pregnancy. A mother might also kill deformed cubs. Such cases include cubs with malformed penises or if an orange tiger gives birth to a white cub in a mixed litter. Sometimes the mother will kill the white cub to give the others a better chance of survival, as the white one would handicap the hiding place of the others. However, these occurrences are rare. Tigers are extremely good mothers and very protective. The greatest danger to the cubs, however, are adult males. To understand this, we have to go a little bit deeper into their social structure. Male tigers control large territories, including the territories of several females. Whilst they are solitary creatures, they do socialize from time to time. Obviously, a male will mate with a female over several days, before continuing to patrol his territory, hunting, checking on the other females, and making sure that no other male intrudes on his domain. However, when a new male enters the territory, he knows that none of the cubs are his, and he hasn't developed social bonds with the current inhabitants. In these circumstances, his instincts are often to kill cubs in order to bring their mothers into season as quickly as possible. Tigresses may fight to defend their young, and there have been cases of them dying from the injuries, but these efforts usually go in vain, as male tigers weigh 70% more than females and therefore are much stronger. Tiger cubs spend the majority of their time playing with their siblings and their mother. Playing helps the growing tiger cubs develop useful life skills such as stalking, pouncing, swatting, and climbing. Apart from protecting her cubs, the tiger mom also has to prepare them for the wild. After spending 2 months hidden, the cubs begin to follow their mother out of the den. However, they do not participate in the hunt at this point. They wait in a safe place for their mother to bring the food back to them. When they are strong enough, at between 8 to 10 months of age, the mother takes her cubs on hunting expeditions to showcase how a kill is made, in the hope that the cubs will mimic her technique. Amongst the cubs themselves, a hierarchical order is established by 16 months of age. Usually the dominant one is the strongest male. This strong cub will always eat first until he is full, and only the leftovers go to his siblings. This dominance plays a big role for when they leave the family unit. At 17 to 24 months old, the cubs are ready to leave their mother in search of their own hunting territory. Male tigers, characterized by their highly curious nature, as well as being stronger due to their dominance, leave earlier and roam far away from their mother. The females and the lowest in the hierarchy are the latest to leave her. You would assume that from now on life will be good to the tiger mom? Well, not that fast. Let's get back to how tigers establish and maintain their territories. The father of the cubs controls the territory where they were born, and inside that territory can be several other females. The males of the family will have to roam away from their father's area or they need to overthrow him, meaning they can't fight their mother. The females, on the other hand, can. The strongest sibling amongst the females will have to challenge her sisters one by one into a battle of submission. The last battle is destined to be mother versus daughter. If the mother is old and not powerful enough, she will be exiled, the same as her other daughters. Usually, the overthrown queen is old by the time she gets challenged, so she submits and has to leave the area. The new queen enjoys the benefits of controlling a familiar territory. Meanwhile, the mother and her other daughters leave, each on their own way. The chances for the overthrown queen to find another free area are low, especially when faced with the extreme loss of their natural habitat. She is no more in her prime, therefore fighting for another territory is not an option, and hunting big prey gets harder and harder by the time. Hoping to find easy prey, she will roam in dangerous territories of other predators or rival tigers. If she is lucky enough to survive another battle, the injuries will make it impossible for her to hunt any prey at all. Therefore, the queen that was overthrown by her own daughter dies of starvation. Do you know other animals that have a tough life? Thank you for watching and consider subscribing.